Welcome to the ADA Professional Product Reviews Product Forum. In this CE session, we will cover the factors that influence the effective use of dental curing units. This presentation summarizes three important topics: curing unit performance and characteristics, energy requirements of polymer-based restorative materials, and clinical technique. Irradiance is a measure of the radiant power striking a specific area. It is reported in watts per square centimeter, or often in milliwatts per square centimeter by manufacturers. From the definition, irradiance is dependent on the area over which it is measured. Because irradiance is dependent on area, irradiance changes as the light-emitting tip of the curing unit is moved away from the surface of a restoration. A simple analogy is flowing water through a hose. When the water is turned on, it flows out of the nozzle at a certain rate, let's say 1 liter per second. When it's held close to the bucket, all of the water is collected. When the nozzle moves away from the bucket, much of the water misses the bucket. The water flow does not change. It is still 1 liter per second, but every second, much of the 1 liter volume misses the bucket. When a dental curing unit is turned on, it radiates light from its emitting tip. The light radiates out of the tip with a certain power expressed in watts. Power is a rate in energy per second. Thus, a watt can be expressed in joules per second, similar to water flow in liters per second. Like the water flowing out of the nozzle, the power does not change with distance. However, as the curing tip is moved away from the restoration, less of the light strikes the restoration. In the illustration, we place the detector on top of the teeth that could collect all of the light, and we remember that irradiance is power incident on a specific area. We can see that the measured irradiance will decrease as it is moved away from the surface of the tooth. This is because the power stays the same, but the area that the power strikes becomes larger. A curing unit must emit a sufficient amount of energy at the proper wavelength to sufficiently cure a light-activated dental polymer. What is the proper wavelength will be discussed later. Energy expressed in the unit of a joule is equal to power times exposure time. In the last slide, we talked about the definition of irradiance and its dependence on area. Now let's look at irradiance and its relation to radiant exposure. Radiant exposure is the total amount of light energy deposited on the light-activated polymer. This quantity, however, is often incorrectly referred to as energy density. Radiant exposure is expressed in joule per square centimeter and is equal to the irradiance times the exposure time. The minimum total amount of light energy required to successfully cure a specific resin-based composite is unique and depends on the formulation, shade, and opacity of the material. This information should be available from the material manufacturer. Using the known irradiance of a curing unit and the manufacturer-specified total light energy requirement, the clinician can implement a sufficient time of exposure in order to deposit the total amount of light energy to adequately cure the specific resin-based composite they are using. Using the hose and bucket analogy, let's say the water is flowing from the nozzle at 1 liter per second and the volume of the bucket is 10 liters. It will take 10 seconds to fill the bucket. Similarly, if the irradiance value given for a curing unit is 1,000 milliwatts per square centimeter, which is the same as 1 joule per second per square centimeter, and the minimum total of light energy required to adequately cure the restorative material is 16 joules per square centimeter, then to adequately cure a 2 millimeter thick increment of material, it takes a minimum of 16 seconds. A curing unit must emit a sufficient amount of energy at the proper wavelength to adequately cure a light-activated polymer. This figure displays representative spectral emission curves for several single-peak LED curing units, along with a few polywave LED curing units and a quartz tungsten halogen unit. Quartz tungsten halogen lights produce a broad range of wavelengths, while LED units produce narrow spectral emission bands, designed for use with specific photoinitiators. Broadband or polywave LED units use two or more different wavelength LEDs for use with a variety of photoinitiators. For proper curing, the curing unit must emit a sufficient amount of energy at the wavelengths within the absorption range for the photoinitiator of the material being cured. This figure displays the spectral emission plots for different LED and quartz tungsten halogen curing units, along with a normalized plot of the absorption spectrum for camphorquinone. Camphorquinone is the most commonly used photoinitiator in dental resin formulations. The region shaded in yellow, from approximately 455 to 481 nanometers, is defined as the approximate peak absorption range for camphorquinone. The spectral emission curves for the different curing units overlap the region representing the peak absorption for camphorquinone to a varying extent. In general, the greater the percentage of the spectral emission curve for a curing unit that overlaps the peak absorption range for camphorquinone, the better. In the figure, the polywave LED units have a peak centered at around 398 to 408 nanometers. These curing units are designed to work with photoinitiators other than camphorquinone. There is a yellow-shaded region from about 375 to 410 nanometers that approximately represents the absorption range for the photoinitiator Lustrin TPO. Representative two-dimensional irradiance distribution images from different curing units at distances from the light-emitting tip. From the images, it can easily be seen that the irradiance is not homogeneous across the light beams of the different LED curing units. The most homogeneous beam comes from the Optilux 501, which is a tungsten halogen curing unit. Single irradiance values reported in product literature for LED curing units can make it seem like the irradiant power emitted from a curing unit is uniformly distributed across its light beam. However, these images show that that is clearly not the case. It can be seen from the color-coded images that the irradiance distribution varies across the light beam for all LED curing units. For example, some profiles, such as the Blue Phase Style and the Smart Light Max, range from below 500 milliwatts per centimeter squared to over 4,000 milliwatts per centimeter squared. Single irradiance values reported in product literature are average values, and these average values will depend on the area over which the radiant power of the curing unit is measured. Light position, LED curing units. Depending on the beam homogeneity, the position of the curing unit, especially a polywave unit, could have a significant effect on proper curing of the resin-based composite. Image A shows a depth of cure mold with its 4 mm inner diameter. Image B shows a 3.9 mm diameter irradiance probe used for the radiant power measurements, which is superimposed over a third molar. And image C shows the beam profile for one of the curing units superimposed over a third molar. The white circle in the middle of the image represents the irradiance probe. A curing unit may have a non-uniform irradiance distribution across its light-emitting tip and/or have multiple LED chips with different spectral emission wavelengths. This is a close-up of the two-dimensional irradiance distribution image at 2 mm from the light-emitting tip for the curing unit shown in image C. Circles 1, 2, and 3 on the image correspond to the approximate position of the 3.9 mm irradiance probe when the spectral emission curves with the corresponding numbers to the left of the image were generated. The circle labeled 3 represents the curing unit positioned with the high irradiance region over the irradiance probe, and it can be seen that the corresponding spectral emission curve labeled 3 shows a single peak centered at 455 nanometers, which comes from a blue LED. Likewise, the circle labeled 1 corresponds to the curing unit positioned over the irradiance probe such that the 455 nanometer peak mostly disappears, while the 408 nanometer peak corresponding to a violet LED becomes larger. This means it is possible that the position of the curing unit can have a significant effect on both the radiant power and the wavelength of the radiated light received by the resin-based composite material, both of which could result in suboptimal curing. For example, if you're placing a Class 1 restorative with a diameter of about 4 mm using a material with camphorquinone as the photoinitiator, it's possible that this curing unit can be positioned such that circle 1 corresponds with the area of the restoration. This would mean that the energy deposited on the polymer will not be at the proper wavelength to optimally interact with the camphorquinone photoinitiator, and could result in suboptimal curing of the material. In summary, for proper curing, you need a sufficient amount of light energy deposited on the polymer at the correct wavelength. Irradiance will decrease as the distance from the restoration to the tip increases. Clinicians can use a depth of cure test to check the performance of the light at varying clinically relevant distances above the restoration. The orientation of the light tip relative to the surface of the restoration site is important and could affect the output of the light and the overall cure of the resin-based composite. The tip of the light should be stabilized parallel to the restoration surface and as close as possible without touching. Inspect and clean the curing unit before use. Debris and adherent resin on the tip of the curing unit can affect light output. Use protective blue-blocking eyewear or a shield and always look at the restoration while it's light cured. Monitor the irradiance of the curing unit using a radiometer on a regular basis to ensure the light is functioning properly. This concludes the CE session of the factors influencing the effective use of dental curing units. Thank you.